Hello, anatomy colleagues. This is Dr. Alsup, and welcome to Station 23, where we are going to look at two of the three intercostal muscles. And let's just get our bearings in terms of what we are seeing here. You can see a little bit of the clavicles, right? And this region here is going to be the sternum. Specifically, this would be the manubrium, and then the body is going to be here. And then we can see some ribs. And of course, with the ribs in between, you'll have those intercostal spaces, which are filled with these intercostal muscles. So the external intercostal muscle is going to be the most superficial, but in this particular dissection, in a few areas, we've actually gone a little bit deeper so you can see the internal intercostals. So for the external intercostal, these are going to have muscle fibers that are going to run inferomedially, as you can see kind of here, from the rib above to the rib below. And you can see that also here. So these would be examples of the internal intercostals. And I always think of these fibers kind of running in the direction if you were putting your hands in your front pocket. That is the same direction that these muscle fibers are running. So that will be the external intercostal. The internal intercostal, which you can see in these three spaces, they have been dissected a little bit deeper. So the external intercostals have been removed. These are the internal intercostals, and these are going to be perpendicular to the external intercostal fibers. So whereas we had the externals kind of going this way, the internal intercostals are going kind of this direction, as you can see here. So perpendicular to those external intercostals. Any of this tendon right here, the external intercostal really just becomes more tendinous in this region. So you kind of lose the muscle bellies the more anterior you get for this region. And so those really, you have to really pay attention to the fibers of the muscles to be able to differentiate between the two. Fortunately, these fibers are going to be similar to what you see in the external obliques, in the abdominal region and the internal obliques. So those muscle fibers will run the same way. So if you remember, those externals are kind of running in this inferomedial direction, that will help with the internal obliques of the abdominal wall. And same thing for the internal intercostals and the oblique muscles of the abdominal wall, they're running in a similar direction. Okay, so those are the intercostal muscles that we're going to have you identify for a practical setting. Please kind of work your way through these muscle fibers and reach out if you have any specific questions in this region. All right, I will see you in the next video. Thanks for your time.